Hi, I'm David Stein of Money for the Rest of Us. And in this video, I answer the question, what do central banks do? Central banks, like the Federal Reserve, the European Central Bank, the Bank of Japan, what do they do? Well, the one thing they do is they set short-term interest rates, policy rates. And they set this short-term interest rate, which is this whole process is known as monetary policy. They set it at a level where they believe the economy will do very well, that everybody that wants a job can get a job, and that capital resources are used efficiently, that there's sufficient borrowing by businesses to invest in projects that they think will be profitable, but there's not too much borrowing, that the economy doesn't run too quickly, that there's not too much overexuberance, such that the ability of the economy to produce goods and services gets stretched. And so then you get inflation or higher prices. How do central banks even know what the rate should be as they set that short-term policy rate? Well, they're trying to set it at a level that matches what is known as the neutral rate, the equilibrium rate, sort of that perfect rate that makes sure the economy is not running too fast or too slow. The problem with this neutral rate of interest, it's unobservable. No central banker, no one knows what that rate is. And what's happened is there's evidence that that neutral rate has been going down over the previous decades. And that's one reason when we look at policy rates, what the central banks have set, for example, the US policy rate right now is 2.5%. And when we talk about policy rate, we're talking about the Fed funds rate. So what this Federal Reserve says is the Fed funds rate, this is the rate that banks borrow from each other overnight. And it's pretty close to the rate that the Federal Reserve pays banks for interest on their excess reserves. So the Federal Reserve sets that policy rate, that target. Right now it's 2.5%. It's not 4% because they believe the neutral rate is closer to 2.5%. Well, there's evidence that that neutral rate has declined. How do we know that? Well, in previous tightening cycles where the Federal Reserve has been raising interest rates, the average real rate, so the rate after inflation, when they're done tightening, has been 3%. The economy has been growing fast enough that the rate got up to 3% real, so inflation was above that. Now we're at 2.5% nominal. If we back out inflation, essentially the real rate, that neutral rate's zero. How do we go from an average of 3 down to zero? Well, there's evidence that certainly aging population has influenced that. The sort of the use of technology, and that just generally speaking, the private sector doesn't want as much stuff. Larry Summers calls it demassification, that we don't need as much stuff, so we're not borrowing as much. Companies aren't willing to borrow as much because they don't think they're necessarily going to sell what they produce. They'd rather just buy back their stock. And as a result, this neutral rate appears to be lower than it was. Now, if the neutral rate's lower than it was, another reason for that is potentially the neutral rate's lower because central banks are keeping rates lower. Sort of a chicken and an egg. We all expect rates will be lower. They are lower, and as a result, sort of that neutral rate is lower. Nobody really knows. Again, it's unobservable. But there's a problem. If that neutral rate really is lower, and the Federal Reserve has done raising rates at 2.5% nominal, there's a concern because when the next recession comes along, the Federal Reserve and other central banks will want to cut that policy rate. They cut the rate in order to stimulate more borrowing. But we're so close to zero. If you're at 2.5% and you cut it down to zero, you hit what's known as the lower bound. They can't lower rates, nominal rates, lower than zero. And that really worries central bankers. They worry that because if rates get back down to zero, that's the policy rate, and the economy still isn't doing very well, that could lead to kind of a downward spiral and where deflation, falling prices, take hold. Kind of a death spiral. Nobody wants to buy anything because they think prices will drop even further. As a result, Federal Reserve, central banks, they don't want that. They're afraid of deflation. And that's why they have an inflation target. That inflation target's not zero, it's around 2.5% or 2% really. And as a result, that's their target. So they kind of have some wiggle room But they've been falling short of that target consistently during this recovery. So one of the things that the Federal Reserve is considering is what's known as inflation targeting. It's a makeup strategy. If they believe that they've fallen short of their inflation target, once the economy continues to expand, they'll be willing to run inflation higher than 2% to kind of make up ground for what was lost. This is very controversial because it depends on how is the private sector going to react to that. Will they start freaking out and start hoarding stuff and thus maybe have very high inflation? We don't know. Or do they just don't believe in what the Federal Reserve is doing? The bottom line is central bankers have to act confident. They have to act like they know what's going to happen, that all their tools work, that they have control of inflation, they have control of the economy. But the reality is they're guessing. They're just guessing at what they think the right rates will be, whether they should continue to raise rates or lower them. And so as investors, we have to protect ourselves. We need to protect ourselves primarily against inflation, rising prices. And the way that we do that is we own gold, we can own rental real estate, we can own land, real assets, things that will hold their value if inflation comes in higher than expected. So that's what central banks do. They set policy rates and try to keep the economy going by making sure they set their interest rates at a level that allows the economy to expand, but not too quickly. If you have any questions on this video, you can go ahead and leave those in the comments. And please subscribe to my channel. Thanks.